So an optional pass to the back of the legs for the Thai massage, and perhaps as an offering for the yoga teachers who have seen the elements, as we come to traction the leg, reaching for the ankle foot junction to literally lift the knees off the floor, and widen the legs wider than our shoulder distance. If the toes will turn in and the heels out, so be it. As the thumbs and fingers glue in, weight bearing at the Achilles, and if it's comfortable, a simple elephant rock side to side, as we're having arms straight and back straight. As you take a few passes here, pressing straight down to the Achilles tendon. And eventually, as this is a great place for weight bearing, perhaps a gentle press out as you step one foot forward for a knee down to begin elephant walk. Now literally tracing up the back of the legs from the Achilles right up the center of the calf. And we're rocking with arms straight, back straight. From the Achilles just to the back of the knee, or more specifically just below the knee, as we're practicing not to press on any major joints or bones. As you might imagine, we could take three passes or stay with the one. As we come back to the Achilles tendon, one more time, a great press for weight bearing to transition back through tabletop, or as you scoop under the heels, rock pose, a gentle traction as you bring your legs closer together, and then as you lift your seat and bend your elbows, begin windshield wipering your legs. So as if they just took a bunch of back bending, say cobras or half bow or full bow, nice gentle back release. From here, slowing down the rocking, as you walk even closer, curl your back toes and slide to open diamond, draping your legs over yours, thumbs and fingers in, turn the fingers out, just above the knee, now pressing up the center of the thigh at the hamstrings. As opposed to the elephant walk, now we're pressing off our toes and doing a double palm press. So the hands land, arms straight, back straight, and you rock body weight forward. As you could imagine, we could do this for several passes. Generally speaking, usually one or three. For now, the one, as we uncurl the toes, and making a gentle clenched fist, soon to come working with this part of your hand for tapping right down the center of the calf, where you are just palming, and eventually towards the lower leg. As you lean back, hold for the ankle foot junction. Give them their weight back as you lift your seat, walk the knees together, and begin to rock side to side one more time, windshield wipering, until you get to about 45 degrees here. Pause, lift and traction the legs one more time. And if it's comfortable to do the internal rotation, toes and heels out, a double palm press onto the feet. As they're ready, you may verbally instruct them to come back to a wide-legged child's pose. And I recommend let them do that on their own as they eventually press through their hands and press back so big toes touch and heels go wide. You're welcome to leave them as they are. You might also choose to give a child's pose assist. And since you're at the back body, coming to goddess squat, heels in, toes out, thumbs and fingers together, turn the fingers back towards you as the giver, and as opposed to pressing straight down, we're going to think back and down as we come to land below where we have the perceived butt line to the top of the hip points, or more so the iliac crest. And as we bend the knees and elevate down, it's an energy of back and down. We sustain for some time. And when it's time to come out, again, through the knees, arms straight, back straight, as you take your weight back. Coming to knee down, if you choose, and taking more of a Thai prayer variation, where the pinky fingers are a little bit wider, and as your elbows are wide, it will be a flicking of the wrist, Rather than muscling, just a gentle flick. As you visualize the spine coming to either side, you might start a little softer and then build a rhythm. And as you get a rhythm, perhaps coming around the shoulder blade on one side, back down the spine, maybe around the hip, and then at the other side of the spine, the scapula, eventually back down the spine, and down the hip. If they are also in a wide-legged child's pose, and it's available, you might come to tap down the very top of the thigh, across the sacrum again. You could come through double kneel to switch to step out on the other side, tapping. And generally speaking, if doing the Thai chop, I like to end very soft, very gentle, up the spine, subtle vibration, back down again, and eventually the hands will meet mid-back as one will go up and one will go down as we invite our person to seat. A gentle draw of the shoulder as we sit back. We might give a gentle squeeze, and or if you know it, or from the other pass, perhaps inviting them to tuck their chin. Soft interlace of the hands, and soon to come a folding of the elbows to make a box with the hand. As we clamp down the neck, and as a reminder, as a nicety, I like to turn my head, as I'll be doing an audible ujjayi breath. I don't want to be breathing right on the receiver. From here, as you make your way back up to the base of the skull, opening the hands as if gently holding a ball and lifting to the base of the skull, first neutralize the head, and then with an audible inhale, lift and traction, and release.